Hey guys, I'd got halfway through doing this missile setup and thought I'd actually record it. So as you can see, I've set up a number of induction plates to feed power to the machines. I've also set up off camera the gold and the copper tubes. Going to fill these up with the missiles and the fuel that I've collected so far, see if it works. There we go, processing. Now I've got to put it to an output hopper. Grain the template from where the fuel is going to go, and I'm going to have to get another refinery set up. Is getting blocked up. Should be interesting to see. I might need to find another way to get gold independent of the rest of them. Never had any luck with filters. If they're not balanced, you know, have one or one for each level of advanced filter, it tends to just block up when it gets too full. Sure, you guys don't want to see all this. Okay guys, we're back. Setting up this refinery, obviously, well, I don't know if you guys know, but you need to have pipes, iron pipes, to make the fuel rods. And it's not really a big deal when all you're doing is you're powering a turbine, because the turbines recycle the empty fuel canisters and they come back out. You cycle them back into the refinery, it refills them back up, and the cycle continues with no loss. Unfortunately, with making missiles, when you feed the missile fueler with your fuel canisters, it actually destroys them, so you don't get your empty fuel canister out of it to feed back into the refinery. So there's got to be an automated setup where you grab your iron, you feed it into a, you know, obviously you convert it to bars, and then you convert it to your iron pipes. Then you feed that into an set up your manufacturing plant to automatic to feed that iron bars to create your pipes. Then you feed that into your refinery, or a storage hopper attached to your refinery control, and that takes the biomass and the empty fuel canisters and creates the full canisters. So yeah, just setting that up at the moment, making sure I've got power and stuff, otherwise this stuff ain't going to run, because the intention here is to smelt at the point of the ore vein, which is what I always do, and I suggest you do too. Yeah, so we'll just carry on and see how that turns out. Create a tunnel to the surface so I don't need to drag the stuff up here, because in the future what I'm going to do is to have a lot of quite a large power transfer from top to bottom, and I don't want to have all of the conveyor belts running up and down the shaft. So we'll wait for this to come up and then we'll continue.
Crafting.
Alright guys, we'll come back when that's actually finished tunneling its way to the surface. Okay guys, that's almost done. While that's just finishing up, let's get the production of this ore, this iron ore, happening. I don't know if these Mark IIs are going to be good enough, but we'll find out. That seems to have finished now. Let's see if it's hit some ore or something like that. Looks like it's pretty clean. It's come up underneath the it's come up underneath my copper tube production. That's alright. We'll just sink it into the dirt. We'll be back when we excavate this stuff. You guys probably saw this, but I didn't realise at the time. I actually stopped the flow of my power to the rest of my base below the 110 level. So I'm just going to fix this up. False floor here. can't believe I just did that. You idiot. Probably said this in some of my videos before, but these space windows, I reckon I played about 1,000 hours of the game. Well, I don't know about that, that might be an exaggeration, but it took me months and months to realize that you could fire lasers through this stuff. So I was always putting lasers one block down to cover it up and to look all flash, and then I've realized one day, oh, I think I can actually, I'll test it, I'll see if I can fire through this glass. And theoretically you can, and you could. And then I was overjoyed. Alright, I'm gonna excavate this stuff, lay down some pipe, get some iron bars to the surface. Be right back. I've changed my mind. I'm going to put my refinery in. So I want to build this quite deep. I'm going to have probably 3 vats running off this, because I believe from experience that's what will feed about 10 missile fuelers and keep up with it. Bet you it's done. You gotta build these things in stages of three. You can't just expect to go, say, if it's, and build two at once, because it won't actually intelligently recognize that you're building from one end where you're trying to build multiples. So it sort of just must be the way it's mechanically configured, but it'll set it up on the middle. Take it to one. Connected to two, that's better. Yeah, it wasn't connecting to the other ones because I built them. Looks like you got to build the one attached to the controller first and then you add to that. Otherwise it won't recognize any other VAT in a multi-VAT system. Prior to the one you built that connects to the controller.
crafting.
Even then, I'm going to lose a block. I don't know why. Now, where am I going to get my biomass from? Oops. Is that titanium? What? Oh, it's grabbing it from the other. Okay, that's something I didn't foresee. That's alright, we'll fix that up. Grabbed it from the adjacent cargo lift. This is sitting right behind a turbine, so it makes it even more dangerous to work. That just took way too long. Okay guys, we'll come back after I finish running this line. Why don't you watch this? It'd be boring. Okay, we'll just going to hook this up, set this to high energy composite fuel. Make sure the conveyor's facing the right way. So I'm going to use Matamu's to push the bars up to the surface, because I'm really liking Matamu's. I've used them a lot in this world, and I'll probably continue to do so, because they are very good. The problem is this stuff has to pass underneath all this other machinery. So let's just get that done. Another one down. Jeez, that was good. Can't put it there because it will pull that biomass out of that hopper. So, run it in the front. guys will be back when I start setting up the machinery for this. Okay guys, so I've got my matter mover set up, just waiting for the first lot to transfer to this hopper. Sometimes it takes a while, sometimes it happens pretty much straight away. There we go. Cool. Iron bars. Right, now I've got to make pipe extrusion plants. But I don't. If that's gonna work, I think. Nah, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I need to iron pipes to then go into manufacturing plants to create the empty canisters, which means I don't have enough room here. Plenty of iron backing up. Got some power down here because manufacturing plants need, I think it's, they take 100 power per second from memory. Maybe it's 10. They don't take any power if you are manually manufacturing stuff, but once it's automated it starts to grab power. Sure if they can, they accept. I think the latest change has been that DJ made it so they accept from a hopper, or they can accept from a belt, or they output to a belt. I can't really remember, but it's only if you've got an item which only uses one ingredient, which this does. So let's hope that what I'm thinking works. We'll be back after we get some more materials. Yeah, guys, that didn't quite work. I do need to have the manufacturing plants take from a hopper. But I'm pretty sure they output, let's hope they do, to a conveyor belt. Because otherwise, you know. Good news is making stuff. No. Damn it.
Crafting.
Alright, well, let's just set these up. Oh, top pressing. Yeah. Too used to hitting the craft button. Which means I'm going to have to put an output hopper here. You lied, DJ. You lied. Seal this up so I don't keep falling down, and hopefully cool, ready to go. It's connected up. Connect this to the middle as opposed to run it in the end like the gold is, because it just distributes it more efficiently. Unfortunately, because it's a one-to-one split, when it hits a turntable, if you've got a run like that where you've got 10 things you need to feed, even if you feed it from the middle, it's still going to fill the center ones first and work its way towards the outside. But at least if you're not going from one end, the far end ones just don't seem to get anything, especially when you're trying to put items into a storage hopper which holds 100. They just never seem to get there. See how it goes. No, I'm not going to do it that way. Okay guys, I'm just going to tidy this up, but at the end of the day, that's done. Just got to connect some conveyors and that's all done. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more, hopefully short, tutorials on the machines of Fortresscraft of old. Thanks. Bye.